Hello everyone, welcome to this demo about IBWave grid testing using IBWave mobile survey and the Epic Prism scanner. In this video, we will look at how to create a project from scratch on IBWave mobile survey, inputting our floor plan, drawing our grids and placing our critical points, to doing our grid tests and to generating our report. First, we'll look at the application settings, where we want to make sure that our units are set to Imperial. In my case, it is already set to Imperial. Next, let's create our project. Going back with the bottom right folding button with the plus sign, I will click on New Project. Now I am prompt to give my project a name. I will call it IBWave Grid Test and then press on Create. This brings you to the project landing page, where you have two tabs, plants and properties. In plants, this is where you can take a look at all the plants and buildings of your project. In my case, by default, building one is created and the default name is building one. Using the three buttons on the right, you can take a look at properties, delete or duplicate a building. And the bottom right button, the floating button again, is used to create a plan. Looking at the properties section now, we have project information, where you can put information about the project type, address, city, state or province, zip code and country. I will give some arbitrary names for this demo. This is the place where you can put the location of the building you're performing the grid test on, and the address and all the information you write here regarding the location of the building will show up in the grid test report later on, as we will see. Next, we'll briefly take a look at client information section. A contact name can be used to put the name of the person performing the grid test. And again, this will show up in the grid test report, and we will see this later, as well as the contact email and contact phone number. And that's it for the property section. These are all the relevant information to fill up for the grid test report. Going back to our plans tab, using the plus floating button in the bottom right again, let's create a floor plan by using select picture. I'll go to my pictures folder where I have the picture of my floor plan and I'll import this. Everything is good as is. I don't need to rotate or anything. I will use this. Now I am on my floor plan view. This right here is used to create the scale. I will drag this along the whole building and set up my scale. Now that my line is set, I will click on it to open the context menu on the top. Using the triple dotted button there, I can set my floor plan scale. I will set it to 300. Now, let's move to the grid testing tab. There are four buttons here. They are placed in the same order as your workflow, as in you would be drawing the grid first, then adding your critical points. The settings button is used to set the thresholds, and then you configure and start the grid test. Now, let's draw a grid. Click on Add Grid button. It will be highlighted in red. Now, if you click and drag on the floor plan, you are drawing your grid. As you can see, if I do it too small, you get a little message in the bottom letting you know that this is smaller than 20 feet per cell. And if you do it too big, you'll get a similar message to let you know it's too big. I am done drawing the grid. I release my finger and now I have my grid. Now, if I click on the grid again, it will select it and open the context menu. The context menu is on the top of the screen. There are three buttons. First one is the delete button. This will delete the grid. Second one is the edit button. This will open the grid settings pop-up. In the grid settings in the bottom, you can see we have a checkbox, an FBA size constraint, checked by default. This will limit the size of the grid to have a minimum of 20 foot per cell size and a maximum of 80. So if you go above or under, it won't let you draw it. And you want 20 cells per grid, as the NFPA documentation recommends. But here, if I change it to 6, I get this warning message that tells me this does not follow the constraint and will not let me leave the screen. Now, if I do want to have a unconventional grid, I just need to uncheck the checkbox, and now I can set as many rows and columns I want. They don't need to add up to 20. As you can see, the warning message was not there. I will check it again, because in my case, this is okay. And I am done. I click elsewhere on the screen, and it's going to leave the grid settings. Now I've clicked the third button in the context menu, which allows me to disable or enable cells inside the grid. So when this is activated, I just click on the cell inside the grid. It will disable it, click it again, and it will enable it back. And that's it for all the capabilities on the grid and the drawing of the grid. Now, let's place some critical points. When you click on the critical button, it is highlighted in red. And now any click on the floor plan will drop some critical points to define your critical areas. Clicked on the critical button on top again to disable this so that I don't drop any more critical points. Now, let's take a look at the settings. So these are our threshold settings. Again, we have a NFPA checkbox there that will populate it with the NFPA thresholds recommended from their documentation. They ask for a power of minus 95 dBm, a DAC score of 3 or higher, and 95% of general areas should pass, and 99% of critical areas. You can choose to add a SINR or a BR if you want. All these values are by default and on read-only when the NFPA threshold checkbox is checked. If you wish to modify those, simply uncheck the Use NFPA Threshold checkbox at the top, and then you can modify any of these fields as the following. You may want to gather something else than average. We have minimum, maximum. You can change these values. And once you are all set and done, click the Save button on the top right, and we're good to go. Now, configure our test and start the test. Here you have the possibility to write a test name. I will put the year that this test has been done. And next, you see that the only technology supported is P25 for now, and we have a list of frequencies. Mine is already populated, as I have added some previously. You can type a new frequency and add it to this list with the plus sign on the right there. Automatically selects it. I'm going to deselect it. I only need the 770.53125 frequency. Now, it's time to connect our scanner. First, make sure you have airplane mode activated and the Wi-Fi is turned off. I will connect the scanner through USB-C to my device now. Once connected, wait until the Ethernet cable connection notification appears here on top. Make sure that it is enabled. I will tap to show you. As you can see, Ethernet, the switch is enabled. If this is not enabled, the device will not be able to communicate with the scanner. And now I'm ready to start the test. I'll click on start. You get a snack bar in the bottom, letting you know that the scanner is initializing. Once ready, the message will change to this to let you know that you can start testing. I'll click on the first test point in cell 1. In this screen, now this is a recording screen. See my cell ID. It is failing for now because it does not have any data. And you have the record button on the top right. As I just clicked it, it will start collecting measurements. Sample count is going up, as you can see. I want to collect up to 30. Then I click on the record button again, which is pause. And this is my collected data. You can see the power, SINR, the DAC that have been collected. We can go back in the same way to collect the next test point. I will collect another 30 sample. As it's collecting, you can see the measurements being updated live in the table. Now that I have 30, I will pause it and leave the screen again. That's how measurements are collected with the grid test. It's essentially the same way with critical points. You simply click on the critical point and the same recording screen will open and you can collect measurements for your critical points. Now, since this is a demo, I will fast forward this and I have collected all my test points and critical point measurements. And now let's take a look at how to generate a report for our grid test. Top, we have a PDF button to generate the report. If you don't see it, it's in the kebab menu on the right because maybe your screen is too small and then the buttons will disappear. In my case, I click on the PDF. You have two parts of the report. Go on grid test and the grid test report section will open. For now, this is empty as there are no customization to this report yet, but they will soon come in future releases. Click on run. You are prompted to choose where you want to save your report. It is now saved and opened for us. As you can see, there is a pass label on the top right because no grids or critical areas have failed the threshold in this project. Then we have the project address and contact information, followed by what are the frequencies that have been tested and what are my thresholds for my general and critical area. And then you see a small section for the equipment used. In this case, we used the Prism scanner with the IPWave mobile survey app. And you have a small table following up, giving you a general summary of how the grid test went throughout the building. For my project, I only have one floor, but if you had multiple floors, then you would have seen all the floors. And if any of the floors would have failed those thresholds, it would have had a red X. Next page is a detailed information of floor one. You would have a detailed page for each floor. In my case, I only have one floor. First section is an image of my floor plan with my grid and critical areas, all marked with a green check mark for pass and red check mark for failure. In my case, only cell two have failed. Second section, we will see detailed information for each grid. In my case, again, I have only one grid on my floor plan, but if I had multiple grids, we would have seen a table for each grid. Grid ID is there for my grid one. I have a pass label again because 95% or more of my general areas have passed and 99% or more of my critical areas have passed. We can see that there is one failure here. The SINR for cell 2 and it's highlighted in red. On that, we are done with this demo today on the grid test feature using IPWave mobile survey with the Prism scanner. Thank you everyone for watching.